Hello, welcome back to the Join Dota League Premier Division EU. This is London Esports versus Left1 TV for game number 2. And listen, can you give us a quick breakdown of game number 1?
Yeah, London Esports won the laning stage, won the mid game, should have won the game, but then they threw trying to go high ground versus sniper. And then they threw even harder. They got pick-offed a few times, maybe tilted a little bit. And Left1 kind of proved to be a little bit more experienced team at the moment. That's it, pretty much.
Yeah, Left1, they stayed cool, they stayed calm, they stayed collective. And they basically capitalized on every little mistake which London Esports made. And that's very frustrating when you've got that far into the game and you've gotten so well, especially against an unfavorable matchup, and then you just can't put the final nail in that coffin, and then every mistake you make gets capitalized upon so well by Left1, and it just snowballs out of control for you. You know, it's a pretty heartbreaking loss, but let's see what they can pull off in game number 2. They're going to pick up the Skywrath, and they're going to pick up the Death Prophet again.
All right. And we go for Warlock instantly. I really like this. I like this so much. Now, let's talk a bit about these two opening picks.
Please
first
go ahead.
Of all, London Esports, they opened up with this Death Prophet because they like her, and I think Andre is comfortable in the hero. The hero is good in the meta right now, definitely, as well. However, this time they do not have the chance, so I'm not certain if they're going to be able to pressure those towers as well as they used to be in the last game. Also, Skywrath Mage does not contribute in that sense at all. What he does very well in the current meta is he pressures lanes. You pick something fat with him on the offlane, something thick, something like an Omni Knight. Well, not really like an Omni Knight, but I guess he can be in that role as well. These two guys go on offlane and they spam the living hell out of your carry. But Left1 picked Warlock. And there's a reason why this guy's banned all the time. It's because these dual lanes don't really work versus Warlock. This hero just spams his Shadow Word, spams it, and you like, what? You're going to run out of mana before he does, and that's the problem. So I kind of like the pickup on Left1 TV. The Nightstalker and the Warlock are both in the meta. Nightstalker got nerfed a bit. The Void mini stun does not work during the day anymore, and Crippling Fear went from 12 seconds, I believe, to 24 seconds.
Yeah,
it's a huge nerf, but it's not really the worst thing. And they go with Leshrac, which is kind of alright. I don't like him versus Omni too much, but I wonder if this is going to be position for Leshrac, because Cube likes to play it on position 4 a lot, and he really hates Nightstalker. So that's what I've heard, at least.
Oh, okay.
It's gonna be Nightstalker offlane and Leshrac position 4, or Leshrac mid. So we'll see. But I don't think Leshrac is actually Stormer hero. So this is Cube on the Lesh.
Okay. When so look at Eskil Nightstalker.
Yeah, Eskil Nightstalker most likely.
Okay.
another position 3 Eskil.
Yeah. Quotation marks.
Yeah, that's what I was doing. You read it perfectly.
Yes, I can see you, dude. I see you in my mind. Well, they're gonna pick up the bait again. So Chowley gonna push that position, you know, maybe position 9, position 10 Bane of 2.5k net worth. And
the courier minutes. In the last game had more net worth than that.
Usually, yeah, average.
Yeah, he averaged like when he was bringing some recipe for a big item for that prophet, he had more net worth than Bane.
Poor Charlie, but we'll see if it's a repeat of last game where they might find himself a couple more items. Something tells me it's just the way this guy plays.
Yeah, I guess, and they just want to control these lanes. They actually are kind of committed super hard on the lanes with their supports. It's not usually what I would draft. Skywrath and Bane. Skywrath kind of scales well in the current meta. Not kind of, he really does scale well, but he's kind of a hero that goes in, selects one target, deletes it from the map, loses all his mana and is useless for the rest of the team fight, right? That's
yeah.
Kyra.
Yeah, absolutely.
Up until some point when you have enough mana items, mana region items that you can actually do something after. And Bane is also kind of similar. He grips one target and that's it. Maybe asleep, maybe enfeeble, but he doesn't do a whole lot. It's not your Leshrac. It's not your Warlock. It's not going to stun everyone and chain them and slow them. You know, it's not like that. Their team fight. What I like about London Esports teamfight this game, though, is that they actually picked a hero that can save that Prophet. So you have this Omni Knight to use Repel on her. She goes in. If things go bad, if things go south, he can use his ulti to save her. He can use the Purification as well. Radiant, so they have that aspect, at least. We have a PL.
Okay. All right. So Phantom Lance coming out. The Man of Many Spears. And this is a pretty nice pickup versus Scarath, I guess. It's a risk of being silenced, though, both by Scarath and the Death Prophet, though, right?
Yeah, I guess he itemizes versus that this game. He gets a Manta, most likely.
Yeah.
To dodge those silences, and that's it. Skyrath overall is decent versus him on the lane. But again, as I said, there's this Warlock guy, and he keeps on healing you no matter how much you get harassed. So, I don't know how much Skyrath is going to be able to do on that lane. We'll soon find out.
We certainly will. Okay, so how do you think London Esports are feeling right now? You know, they let game one go.
They're tilted, man. No. They're
shaking
not talking.
With rage.
It's fine, you know. Like, these teams, they're used to losing.
Ooh. Damn, dude. I don't think that was intentional, kidding. But...
No. I'm kidding. It's just that, like, I'm the same, you know? Like, you have your team with, like, 60% win rate, and you're used to this. You're used to throwing. It happens. It's the game of Dota, you know? You just learn from your mistakes, and you do better this game, and that's it. I was really surprised by how well London Esports played the early game. However, if you remember when they first dove under the tier 1 for that sniper, that kind of gave me a glimpse into the future of what might happen.
I see your clairvoyance perked up and you kind of went, yeah. Uh-oh, this could go downhill.
Yeah, so this game, if they win the laning stage, however, you have to keep in mind, their lanes are not looking as strong as they did the last game.
No, that's true. But they still got the Sky, they still got the, you know, the Bane.
Yeah. They do have these two completely in stompers, but on the other hand, you have the Warlock, you have the Night Stalker and the Leshrac. The thing is, once Night is there, this Night Stalker doesn't really care a lot about Skyrath Mage. It doesn't really care a lot about Bane. He can run circles around them, fear them, void them. 10 seconds remaining. Lash is kind of strong versus them too. We'll see. The last pick is, I think, Lina. Wow. Oh, I called that so well.
Definitely did. Can't take that one. Alright, call London Esports pick now then. No, they need to carry. What are they going to go for?
Wait,
I want it now, Dan.
Wait, I'll tell you right now. Spectre would be good, I think.
Incredible. He gets it right every time, guys. I don't know how he does it, you know. This guy is the best co-caster. What can I say? Well, there you go. So, Spectre versus a Phantom Lancer in terms of carry versus carry. Is this London Esports going for a bit of a later win, or are they just kind of assuming that they can get the lanes going well enough to make sure that Spectre secures itself some early farm, and maybe get a quick Radiance or something?
I mean, they can just play like this. They have this Death Prophet, they play around her until Spectre has her items, so this Death Prophet is the girl that carries them through the mid-game until the Spectre is online, and then they start utilizing her. That's pretty much it. On the other side, you have the same thing with Stormer's Lina. However, both Lina and Vagamama's PL, these heroes can work before they have this one item, but usually you want to see that Yule's on Lina in this meta, and usually you want to see that Diffusal on your PL before they actually join any fights. So we'll kind of see what LOTV does with their heroes. While it looks very simple for London Esports, it doesn't look as simple for LOTV. But LOTV's teamfight looks pretty darn scary, actually.
It certainly does. I'm interested to see how much this Spectre can do, because I really feel like she's kind of the focal point of these team fights, and there is a lot of damage coming out, which is going to be reflected with that dispersion as well. So, I mean, I think it's definitely a Blademail game for her, right?
Yeah, Blademail would not be bad at all. Blademail would be great. We'll see. There are many builds that she can opt for, right? It kind of depends on the way her laning stage goes, too. It's not even about the matchups alone. Like, you can't really go for that quick radiance if you've been stomped on the lane, right? You can sometimes even opt for that urn build, which isn't kind of in the meta as much as it used to be, but it's still a good pickup on her. We'll see. The problem with the Spectre is the broken lane with Spectre is the Warlock lane. Warlock and Spectre. However, they've been denied that pick, and LOTV took it. So I don't know how much this Spectre is going to be able to sustain versus Cube, Slashrek, and Eskil's Nightstalker. They're going to be pressuring her hard.
That feels like a pretty painful lane. Can we talk about Phantom Lancer and the fact that he's brought 3 Mangos to this lane? So he's looking to throw down some Spirit Lancers.
This is basically the good luck F. Good luck HF. You need to remember that. Capital F with the dot.
Is that Swedish spelling?
No, that's not Swedish. That's a meme in the tier 2 scene. There's this one player. He's a support player, and his nickname starts with F, and that's how he would say good luck. Have
right.
fun.
Okay.
So he kind of became a meme in between all these teams. Anyway, 3 Mangos and 6 Tangos. That's usually what you see on an offlaner, and that's what you see on Eskil right now on his.
Come with me taking a bit of damage up at top, but they don't really have. Well, they're actually going to go for a second Spirit Lancer with the Shadow Word as well. I think Come with Me could be in trouble, despite the heals coming out, though. The return harass onto Wagga may well just make this worth it. And Come with Me even comes forward to take the rune, but the Shadow Word is there. That's what we're thinking.
However,
is it going to be enough? Is it going to be enough? No, it doesn't look like it, does it?
Nope.
Well, there you go. There you go. He does survive. So no blood being drawn. Wagga going to have to start chipping away through those tangos.
But this is the thing. The Skyrat needs to go base, while on the other hand, you have Holby's Warlock, and he can just Shadow Word you and keep you there. So this Omni Knight is going to be without any help for the first wave. Come with me, he's going to have to port, most likely. And
if the Omni Knight's able to stay up here, then it's okay, because he can get solo XP, which is going to be not so bad for them. And it doesn't look like they're able to zone him out, I guess.
Yeah. They didn't zone him out, and they didn't get any denies, which is more important for him, actually.
Right.
On bottom lane, they're going on Eskil.
Certainly are. Into the tree line we go, and with that dagger flying vision, looks like they may well just be able to finish the job. One more hit will be needed, but Zibby finds it. Charlie takes a little bit of damage in return, but it's not enough.
That was kind of unexpected, and these lanes do not look really good for LOTV right now. Vaga is completely zoned out on top. Warlock is not healing him. Warlock is instead trading hits, trying to deny. And Vaga is just standing next to his tower.
Yep, these Shadow Words will need to be thrown onto Wagga if they want to keep him up in this lane, but the harass from the Skywrath and Mad Kings as well, just kind of zoning out this Phantom Lancers, isn't what they expected to happen. But,
yeah, and the bottom lane too, like, you don't really expect Nightstalker and Leshak to die versus Spectre and Bane. Yeah, Spectre and Bane, they're kind of tanky, they're strong, but it's not really a lane that in which Nightstalker should die.
Yeah, quite surprising. Well, Charlie taking a bit of harass from Cute Pig. Once they get the levels up, maybe that will change things over, and certainly nighttime might show a bit of dominance.
Yeah, it's just about the nighttime, basically.
All right, so middle lane, it's a slightly more equal story in the middle lane.
Not middle lane, top lane, Vaga.
He's getting under tower, and the heals aren't enough. They will bring him down. However, there's a bit of damage out onto Skywrath Mage and TV. Does he get it? He doesn't quite. Oh, he doesn't have the mana. Oh, yeah, he's got a mango if he gets close enough to come with me. But come with me. Playing it very safe, just holding back, and gets healed up by the Omni Knight there, so.
I feel that they're misplaying this lane a little bit, like, on top, because they're being a little bit too aggressive, and when you're playing this world of lane, which I have played a million times right now, is like, you want to be passive. You don't want to, like, the only thing that you want to do is realize that they want to be as aggressive as possible. That's what they drafted for. So if you just stand back, heal your carry, and that's it, it's going to frustrate them to the point in which they'll think that they're wasting their resources there. But if you fight them, if you try trading hits, if you try trading mana with Fatal Bonds and all that, then they might just turn at one point and kill your carry like they just did.
Yeah, well, Zibby and Chaoli trying to put some pressure on to keep there, just with a dagger and better for us.
Or mid lane, though.
As well.
Stormer.
Stormer could be going down here. Comes in as well, but Death Prophet getting very low, and the Dragon Slave will finish off the DP, and Stormer just fighting it up, but there's the Arcane Bolt from Come With Me. Very intelligently done, I think, from the Skywrath to get right in close there to make sure that he does get that Arcane Bolt off.
Yeah, but at the same time, the Lina got the Death Prophet off first.
Yeah, that, no, absolutely huge for the
so good for Storm.
Well, Eskil taking a bit of damage. Well. He did indeed, he went down the bottom lane. This is very worrying for LOTV. I don't feel like, as you say, I don't feel like they should be really losing these lanes as they are.
Yeah, definitely. But at least Storm is having a good game. He's level 5 versus Death Prophet's 4, so that's kind of good. And Come With Me realizes which lane is to be pressured the most, and that's why he's here. Top lane is kind of won already. Omni Knight is having a good time. However, Vaga is free, just so you know. He's 19 CS versus Spectre's 22, so it's not.
Yeah,
it's not bad in any way. Yeah.
Mad King's doing okay, but it's kind of turned into a solo lane as Come With Me making his way back up now, and he's going to be hitting really hard with these two null talismans and the double damage rune as well. I mean, this is 140 damage this early on in the game.
I mean, he hits hard. However, he did not opt to go for two arcane bolts. So it's not as hard as it could have been, but it's good.
Oh, you mean in the levels, yeah.
Yeah, he never
meant the talent, and I was like, that's, gotta get a bit ahead of yourself then.
No. He went 2 in concussive shots, so instead of going 2 in arcane bolts.
Yeah.
It's alright, you can do either build, like, both builds work really well. However, I feel like when you have two early null talismans and when you're doing so much pressure, getting 2 levels in arcane is good. What's better in concussive shot is that it scales in damage.
For Chaoli at bottom, and they will cancel his TP as well with a void. So it's dropped there. The stun comes out as well from Cube, and they will finish off the Bane. Nice little keg pickoff for them. Gonna hopefully bring things back on track and maybe help them zone out Zibby a little bit here.
Definitely. He kind of forgot that it's nighttime. He didn't really. Yeah.
He should know.
He forgot that he's playing versus Night Stalker, not Day Stalker, so.
Exactly. Night Stalker is, nighttime is Eskil's time.
Yeah. Pretty much. I wonder what Eskil is gonna do. Is he gonna just continue pressuring the Spectre, which is most likely the case, or is he gonna try and rotate a little bit out of this lane? Or is it gonna be Cube that actually plays position 4 at this game? Yeah, here we go. Cube is kind of rotating out. Because right now Lina has ult. She has region and ult, so he's probably saying, guys, plus one, this mid is rip. And that's happening. Cube is moving mid, spinging on the Krobles. Lina is using region to get mana.
Here we go. Lightning and stomp. Nicely dodged by Andre, however. And we'll also get the LSA off, though, and with the ultimate from the Guna Blade, that is enough to find that kill. So just need an extra little bit of magic damage there from Cube to be able to finish the job onto that Death Prophet.
Very well played from them. Even though they missed the splitter, the Light Strike array was on point.
Yep, great button pressing there, for sure.
Yeah, they pressed their spell so well. No, it wasn't only that, it was the rotation. It was the rotation from Cube, and what surprised me is the fact that they spotted it, right? The Bane saw Cube moving away from bottom lane, so where can he actually go from bot when he's moving mid, then mid? So, I don't know, Andre was a little bit out of position there in any way.
They're trying to take down the Spectre with a Split Earth there, and then swapping out the Nightmare to allow Eskil to come forwards here, and he might even be able to bring down the Death Spectre. Yes, he certainly can. Eyes turn to the Bane now, however, as a stomp again on point from Cube, and with the damage from Eskil, they're able to bring him down before the Omni Knight can TP in.
Oh, this is just perfect for LOTV right now. It's not only that, like, Spectre does not want to port top, and we'll see what she does. Nah, she doesn't port top, she goes back bottom. And this is just perfect for LOTV. They forced Omni Knight to port bottom, so his only play right now is to go either jungle or run top, and each one of those plays is equally bad.
Yeah, absolutely. Keep being run down by the Skywrath Mage. Those 2 points in concussive shot. Split Earth does miss. Come with me, still trying to give chase with the silence out from Well. Zibby's here with the dagger. Do they have enough damage? They certainly do. And the concussive shot will finish the door, but now Eskil coming in, wants to get a kill here, Zibby. Well, he's got no TP available, actually, so Zibby could be in a lot of trouble here, trying to run through the tree lines. In comes Stormer, Lina, is storming through.
Void, Eskil.
There goes the Dragon Slave, however. Yep, cancelled by the punch from Eskil. They will finish this off now, despite missing a lot of spells. But they're able to finish the job.
They did miss, but it's alright, they got the kill in the end. Some space was made for Andre to use his ulti on mid, for Death Prophet to use ult and pressure the tower a bit, but not a whole lot was done though. Cube is already here, and unless he's unable to defend it, which looks...
Stormstorm is here as well, but...
Yeah. On top lane though, Vaga.
Uh-oh, into the tree line he goes, being chased down by the Omni Knight, and they will be able to finish the job there. Now, Ovi could be in trouble. There comes another Arcane Bolt. It's just too much magic damage, and that's going to be a double kill for Come With Me. So Skywrath Mage possibly... Is this his strongest point in the game for the Skywrath? Is just when he picks up these two Null Talismans in the laning phase?
Pretty much. These two Null Talismans and these two Bracers. This is when he's the strongest. I mean, in the laning stage, definitely. After that, at one point, he's going to have the Atos. That's why he built the two Bracers, besides them being super cost-efficient.
Cancels the stomp as Cube now has to run away.
What a spell!
And oh, turnaround! Stormstorm is here! Do they have the damage to bring down the Omni Knight? Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
So even though they
Wagga's coming in as well, this is a vicious fight over this bounty rune. They're gonna take yet another name here. And Wagga's not done. Or is he done? I think he should be done.
He's done. He wasn't done, but he cancelled his Phantom Rush on the low ground, so he's done. But however, it's definitely worth it. Only Cube died and they got Omni Knight there. That's great.
Yeah, pretty good fight, all things considered. Well, Death Prophet looking towards her Yul Scepter as a teammate uses the shrine from right next door and force her to go back to base.
Tilting a little bit right now.
I would be.
Yeah, what they need to do is they need to use this exorcism on another tower now with Omni Knight, and that's their play. However, most likely there's a tome. Is there a tome? There's a tome for Hovi. For Hovite's warlock. And
ultimate used rip. Onto the Bane. Onto the Wagamama.
From the Bane onto the Wagamama.
Yeah. We got there in the end.
You needed to be a little bit more careful there.
Yeah Wagga just. Allowing them to get an easy pick, unfortunately. And now we're going to go for the tier 1 at top. And where is your Death Prophet? She's coming in. Slowly but surely.
Actually, she's coming in. I'm not certain if they'll need her. Most likely will. But yeah, they'll need her. They're going in. Warlock did use this Tome right now. So he has his level 6 and they have the Night Time. However, PL ported bottom. So Death Prophet was unnecessary here. They did not need her. She could have went anywhere else. But it's alright, pushing with your... Maybe they force the tier 2.
Well, yeah, I was gonna say, a tier 2 isn't completely off the cards. They have the, you know, Death Prophet, Skywrath, Omni. These guys are all hitting a kind of, you know, the Skywrath is peak of the game, the other two with the kind of mini peaks, so...
He's not in the best position with Warlock right now because of this ward. If the Bane catches him, that would be a free tier 2, actually. Because there's a Spectre with ultimate as well.
Yeah, they're just going for him here. They see him, they're going. Get everyone in position, and now they'll just tear him apart, so... I feel like that's also the tome kind of gone to waste.
And there's the catapult there, so... Like, yeah, LOTV wants to split, but...
What do they have?
It's not really optimal. It's not really optimal for them. I don't think they...
They're not gonna take anything with that, surely. Oh, they do have... No, they don't even have Diabolic Edict, and...
Nah,
London Esports aren't done.
It's not possible. So yeah, they kinda got
Okay, so they're
that's it.
Definitely was the case, and it's going to be a full TP. Can they get the cancel though? Charlie actually backs out, and they'll get Yules out onto the Omni Knight. Spectre pops her ulti. I'm not quite too sure. Yeah, oh, they're going for the Wagger at bottom. Yeah. And the Arcane Bolt. Is he going to have anything to avoid it? He certainly does not. Is it going to be enough damage though? Not quite, but the Crypt Swarm will do the job as Andre picks up that kill onto the enemy carry.
Yeah, they got the tower kind of low on bottom. The tier 2 is quite low, to be honest, so that's kind of good. However, I believe this wasn't the greatest play because Grip was off, if you remember. Grip was used on tier 1 on Vaga, so him porting bottom is kind of questionable. I think they should have fought the tier 2 on top, definitely. It was nighttime, they had the rock. Again, they're kind of playing on London Esports and Come With Me's tempo. And Come With Me is kind of directing the game right now. He's adjusting the pace of the game accordingly to his needs. And LOTV is just letting it happen again.
His team's needs. Well, the Battle of the Silence, yeah. Isn't it? It's going to be the Skywrath who gets the silence off first. Radiant's top
tower is under attack. Doggo?
Oh. Yeah, the dog's excited about what's about to happen. But I don't think there's actually going to be any action. Although Stormstormer... Yeah, he gets out of there, no problem. So, full disengage from LOTV. And that's it. So, yeah, back we go. And yeah, so Jib actually doesn't go for the blade mail, going straight for the Radiance this game. How do you feel about that? Does it make you angry? Does it make you sad?
The laning stage went fairly well for them, so why not? Overall, that's how I feel about the hero. It all depends on... It's not just a match.
Mad
hero.
King's up at top, could be in trouble. The Omni Knight being jumped on by Eskil, Cube, and over T. And even popping the Golem to break that TP. Why not? GA abused, of all things. Okay.
Alright. Someone did not read the spell's descriptions, I suppose.
Maybe. Yeah, they got more than enough damage to through that.
Alina called the beam.
Oh, another big pickoff actually there. And oh, Come With Me comes forwards. Come With Me may have some heroes coming with him right now, and maybe that's not what he wants.
Well, I don't think they want to come with him though.
Well, we'll about to find out. LSA is off the mark as Cube comes in, and we'll be able to finish off that. Oh man, this is just LOTV running forwards here. They're just going for them. And yeah. From a disadvantage to a 3k advantage in a very short time indeed.
It's just what happens once this Lina gets her Yules and these first pickoffs. It's basically insane. However, I don't know why Skywrath went in that deep, to be honest. He only had the Dead Prophet, and the Dead Prophet doesn't even have Yules at this point. I mean, she does now, but did she have it? She had it, right? Never mind, she had
just
it,
now?
But...
Yeah.
But I don't know. Yeah, the Courier delivered it over the trees during that fight, so...
Oh, okay.
It wasn't really optimal.
Well, Zibby, I mean, so this is one of the problems with rushing the Radiance, is that before you have it, you literally carry with phase boots and a killer, so it really, getting lane farm is almost impossible sometimes. In times
like this.
You really
aren't doing a lot in teamfights either. There's that too.
Yeah.
Maybe Come With Me's idea was, alright, we're gonna go on these dudes and it's two of us, however, we have Spectre with ulti, she can connect, but... What's Spectre with phase boots gonna do there? Like, not a whole lot.
Exactly.
Especially if she's rushing for that Radiance, she doesn't really wanna even make that gamble, right? She doesn't wanna go in and maybe get a kill, but maybe die afterwards.
Now, I like this heads-up play from London. They've predicted that LOTV are gonna be going for at least get some information on their Spectre, so they do get up a freebie because of that. This makes sense, right? Like, LOTV, they need to shut down the... The spec.
Wow. Yeah, definitely. They need to take advantage of these wards that they...
Yeah, Colin, he's going for it. He drops the Mystic Flare onto OTV there and no problems. Sorry, OTV.
Bottom lane Bane. Rip.
Uh-oh.
Death Prophet is going in again. Way too deep again, in my opinion.
You reckon? Well, popping the ulti, but the counter Yules is out. And then with the stun as well, Lightstrike... Sorry, the Vaguna Blade as well. And that is a pretty easy one, Jimmy. How can you play around this fight? He pops the ultimate, but for what cause? For what reason? And just seems like confusion's the aim of the game. Meanwhile, this is Mad King's getting stunned up, taking a bit of damage. Wagamama, he's trying to play around the tree line. Come with me, it's here. Actually, the concussive shot going on the wrong here, and they'll be able to take down the Skyrath. Meanwhile, JB coming in the back, but getting earned up as he goes by. Eskia with the flying vision at the nighttime will be able to find the Spectre, and this is a full five-man team wipe because the Bane just respawned.
They just outmaneuvered them so well. I mean, yeah, it all started with that Prophet going in way too deep without even checking. Like, Lina did not use her Yules, so yeah, you can blow her up if she has no Yules, but with that Yules, it's very unlikely that you're gonna kill her before her team shows up there. After all that happened, the team fight that proceeded was just ridiculous. Everyone was super low. Vaga was low, Lina was low, and they couldn't really commit to hitting either Omni Knight or Spectre. But this tanky Night Stalker just stood in front and just destroyed them all. So.
He just did his business.
Yeah.
Did his business all over their faces. And Skywrath Mage falls from great heights. Man, this laner is just striking fears into every member on the side of London Esports right now. And where are we on the Radiant Summiter? Well, still a fair way to go.
And he's creating a ton of space with this Lina and just striking fear into them.
Absolutely. They don't know where to go. They don't know where to hide. I'm just all thrown right now. I mean, thankfully, he's gone back for mana right about now, but it's only a small window of opportunity. And look at this, queuing up the Lincolns next. And this is an item which
says...
He has
no mana. Let's farm, guys. He has no mana. You have 30 seconds to farm.
Quickly, your creeps.
You know what? The last game, LOTV had a stronger late game, as we said at the start. And the longer the game went, it kind of suited them more, right? Because they played versus a champ, they played versus a pushing lineup. This time, it's not really the case. They are playing versus Spectre. They do have PL and Lina to kind of deal with her, but it's not great, and they should be shutting her down even more. She's going to have that relic very soon now.
Okay,
but
well.
Don't get me wrong, LOTV's late game is super strong too. Warlock and Leshak supports, they provide a ton of damage to her team fights later on and a ton of control too.
That's very red seeing supports, but Yule's on Yule's action as Cube's actually the one being brought down here, biting off a bit more than he can chew and trying to go for a solo kill or something. I'm not really too sure what he was doing this far out the lane, or maybe just pushing out creeps, pushing out towers. But did eventually get punished for it.
He's just way too greedy. No, not way too greedy, honestly. I kind of expressed myself wrong. He should be this greedy. He should be pushing out and punished. Because once they show like that, Spectre is not safe. If they see Spectre anywhere else, they instantly know that she's alone and she's an easy kill. So it's one of those position 4 things that you just have to do at some point in some games. Stormer on bottom, just chilling, going for that Lincolns.
Yeah, pushing out really far. So, and this Lincolns is basically going to mean that she wins the 1v1s versus the Death Prophet every time now, right? Because of those Yules.
Yules on Yules actions are not going to be as easy for Death Prophet any longer.
Exactly.
I'm not certain if it's only that. Like, Spectre, rip.
Oh, that's a big kill up in the top lane.
And this guy's gonna fall as well. Come with me.
Yeah, come with me. He's really got nowhere to go. The Yules is up from the Lina, and they will finish off that Skywrath. No difficulty at all there from LOTV as they keep finding kills around this map, and this time it's on that key target of the spec. She did buy her Sacred Relic. She was a fair bit of a way into the recipe as well, but it's still not gonna be a horrible timing on this Radiance.
It's all about what they can do right now after killing her. Can they actually take this tier 2 or not? Can they take maybe tier 2 on mid? Can they make any sort of... Are they just content with making kills? That's the real question, because in my mind I think they are. Like, eventually that Spectre, yeah, she's a super late game hero, but she cannot win you the game alone. Not versus these heroes at least, because remember, they also scale very, very well.
And this Lincolns is gonna be online soon. Probably before the it's actually got the
buffer. Yeah, already there.
It out. Let's go.
I mean, it's not the most important item. It's great. I'm not certain if I agree with it either, to be honest. It's good versus Skywrath. It's good versus Vayne. I think what this team needs is a force, and I don't see anyone buying that force. No one at all. Maybe Hoey gets one later on.
Yeah, I see what you're going for there, though. Like, it's I haven't really seen Lincolns on Lina too much. Only when there's like a Doom or something in the game, and which I don't know if you noticed, but there isn't. So yeah,
There's Bane and there's Skywrath. I guess that's my opinion. There's also the dagger Spectre to follow her around once she ults. So there's a way for Lina to escape, but on mid lane,
they're gonna be able to bring down Hovi. Actually go for more though. Exorcism pop, let's go. Stormstormer could be in trouble. In comes the Spectre, looking to get the kill onto this Lina, and they will get it together as a team. Now straight into the Roche pit we go. The Exorcism's really going, and I love this efficiency from London Esports right now. Get a couple of pickoffs, and let's go say hello to the big boy.
They are not willing to give this rush away. That is Bodak.
That skill's just gonna sit on the front lines here. Waga sending some illusions in. There's that GA pop, but the rock comes down onto four. What can it do though? What do they have? Waga popping down to the low ground. Exactly. That's what the rock's saying. Meanwhile, there's actually gonna be Zibby popped out on the side of the fight. This is two kills already from LOTV. Make it three as the Omni Knight's struggling to get away from this one. And this Roche attempt has gone from looking like a really good idea to looking to a pretty horrible game losing idea.
Yep. I mean, going Rush versus a Warlock with the Rock is great if he doesn't buyback, but if he buybacks, it's not so awesome instantly after. They reused the Courier from Stormstormer a couple of times, so he couldn't get his Lincolns. By the way, oh no! The Courier! 10 HP. Crazy Ancient Thunderhide taking the side of Radiant, almost killing it.
Wait, what? Lincolns. Why is it even awake?
It just happens sometimes. Maybe someone hit him before and the aggro remained on him. It's just weird. It's one of those weird interactions. I can't really explain. Sometimes creeps just start hitting your career.
Triceratops is bored and looking to go.
Yeah.
Once I hit stuff.
I mean, that would be actually big because it would delay the Lincolns even further. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. However, Vaga is pretty
Lincolns?
Thick.
Who's buying Lincolns?
No, it will delay Lina's Lincolns. Lincolns was still in the courier, that's why. Nothing more. She didn't have it. Feels bad, man.
Okay. Well, thankfully, she got it, and that now meant that London Esports didn't get a big break there. However, this Radiance is now up, so...
Yeah. This is Bane gonna be up, though. Nice entry, nice ward. This prevents Stormstormer from getting a... easy pick off once more.
Stormstormer gonna find the Omni, but Omni, it's a game of Yules. Everybody has a Yules this game, it feels like.
Yeah, and he's very deep though, because they do see Waga and Leshrac on mid, so. Alright, they're gonna go for Waga instead, but he has the Aegis, remember, so.
Yeah, Aegis and Invis, and that should be enough to help him get away as they can't find the right one as they throw it out. Why are you taking quite a lot of that Mystic Flare, but in we go, and the backline's gonna blow up the Death Prophet immediately. Come with me, also in trouble, as Wagon's chasing him down. Might be silenced up, but it does not matter. It's able to bring him down, but the double kill with the Crypts on the buyback with that Death Prophet, and it's don't work so far, but what more can it do? Wagamama, he's getting low. He does have that Aegis, do not forget. Try and live through this fight, but he is finding himself all alone as the Lina is dead, the Warlock is dead, the Leshrac is dead, and it looks like the Phantom Lancer.
Nope.
He's got to walk into a ward.
Sadly.
Well, trying to get down the hill, but it's not quite enough. And they finish off Wagamama, so a big fight from London Esports.
He just ran into that sentry, sadly, so that was kind of unfortunate for him. And that Prophet did buy back, but they still took the Aegis off of DL and completely team wiped them. Only Eskil survived, which is kind of big because he's the gem carrier. But overall, London Esports proving to not be quite out of this game. They do have the Radiance and Spectre, and it proved to be super strong in the last fight. Not only Radiance anymore, though. He has Radiance and 2.1k gold. We'll see what he opts to go for.
Jeez, that is such a big gold swing for him. Yep. LOTV, they're still ahead by 10k, but it doesn't feel like it's as scary as it once was. I'm still surprised they won that fight so well, but that buyback from the Death Prophet, no hesitation, immediate buyback, TP to the shrine. It's a danger of fighting so close to these shrines, and
Exactly. It's not only the buyback, it's the fact that they fought without the Warlock ulti, so there was that.
Yeah, middle lane, they're going to drop Mystic Flare onto Eskil here, but he's going to be alright.
Yeah, it's kind of scratched him a little bit. And
yeah, with
it.
The creeps, there's like, Shibby could be in trouble. It's
missing
getting
so
taken
many
down,
hits.
But yeah, just can't find the hit. Now Stormstorm on the high ground, trying to turn it around, but actually dies. Meanwhile, Wago will actually find Death Prophet down in the bottom lane. So kills going on all over the place. Trades happening.
Trades?
Well.
Nice trades.
I mean, cross-map trades, you know, in a way, yeah, in a way.
Stormer almost had him there, to be honest. It was just unfortunate for him. He missed like 5 hits in a row or even 6, so. Crimson Guard is complete on Eskel, so. This Nightstalker is much better already than that Axe ever was.
Yeah, it's true. It's true.
Gem.
And where is... I mean, Cube's got money as well. Like, Cube's sitting on Neon Disc and a Yule Scepter, so they both managed to find their money, but, yeah, it's actually... Yeah.
I'm not surprised. I'm not even clicking on Cube. Every time I click on him, there's a new item now. What? How? Didn't you just finish that one? Well, what are you doing, man? Leave some farm to your PL. Come on.
No, Cube needs it. He needs it. Except when he's on Tusk. You never give Cube... farm when he's on Tusk because he'll buy an Aghanim Scepter and he'll throw the game.
Alright. I played versus... like, on the Vaga camp, we once had to fill in for the teams that had no 5th player. So I was on one team. The team was filled with 3,000 MMR players and he was in the other team. And apparently we were not supposed to try hard, you know, to kind of have them lead and play the game.
Okay.
He just played the Toskar with Radiance, AC, Blink, Agnes, Heart of Tarrasque, Shivas. He had like 9 slots. And that Bane is definitely not good.
But did he get an
Agnes
though?
Yeah, he got an Axe.
Oh, okay. Alright. And they didn't throw? Bottom lane is going off though, as the Golem has dropped. They're going hard. Bring down Stormstormer. And they're just trying to go for more here. Cube's Aeon Disc does run out, and he will be dropped after GA popped as well. Allows them to keep on going, keep on fighting, trying to run down Eskil. Can they do it? I think they certainly can. Helps if you're now realizing that maybe Eskil out. So Wagamama coming in though. He's looking for a fight right now. He's silenced up, but he has got plenty of illusions to hide behind. However, the silence finally runs out on him. But Zibby, no problems at all. He's got that Radiance and the Repel. Meanwhile, Come With Me picks off the Warlock on the side of this fight, and it does look like it's going to be a very successful fight yet again for London Esports, and another big chunk out of the LOTV advantage.
Yeah, I think LOTV needs to take a step back right now and figure out what's going wrong in the fight. In my opinion, they actually
I could jump going back in.
All right.
Madman.
I don't think that's...
Still going back in. He keeps on going back in. He really wants a piece of Jimmy here.
Yeah.
And Jimmy just turns around and kills him. Unsurprisingly. He's got his whole team behind him. It was a bold play. And it did not pay off.
Yeah. Yeah, alright. Nice play. I mean, you can't really go on anyone unless you killed Omni Knight and that's it. Yeah, I mean, even if there was no Omni Knight there, I sincerely doubt that he'd be able to kill that Spectre. But I think what they need to realize is that this Omni Knight is causing them the most trouble in these teamfights, and they have to get him out of the game before they do anything. That's pretty much it. On top lane, Cube, the greedy one.
Uh-oh.
The greedy
one. They're just giving Zibby free kills here, it feels like.
Yeah, free kills. Like... They gave Come With Me the gem, I think, as well, right? The gem was retrieved. It's on Omni Knight right now.
Oh, could they get Stormstormer as well? The Yules is out. Is it enough? I don't think it is. Nope. Mystic Flare gonna finish the job. And London Esports, they're making good rotations around this map right now.
They're just playing the way they should be around this Omni Knight, while Spectre is completely off on the other side of the map farming. And they're getting, I mean, they're getting some pickoffs that they shouldn't be getting, like on this Lina. On the PL, I don't understand that move from Vagas. So.
Sure, but they've also got the ultimate available for that Spectre, so she can be involved in any fight she wants to be. And we may well see that right now as they're diving really deep for this one. Do you have the heart on Vaga though? That is something. Well, X isn't being popped, they're actually looking for something right now, but now comes that ultimate from the Spectre, unable to finish off the Skywrath, now going in for Wagamama. Can he get away from this one? He's trying to get back to his base, but Zibby is just chasing him down, and he will find the kill. The Golem has dropped too late. Wagamama is already dead. Absolutely not. They can't get the Lina back in this fight, but do they really want to? Maybe they just say farewell to their barracks, and then they actually throw the Omni Knight back up into the air and follow it up with a spinner. Shadow Fiend is punching him in the face, and by that, of course, I mean the Golem. Mad King's trying to get out, but he just repels himself and runs away. Can they finish off this tier 3 tower? Well, they're gonna have to stick around for it if they want to. Looks like they will be able to put in the final blow as the Atos comes forwards onto Eskil here. Zebby really wants to finish off this tower. 4 HP left on it, and it's actually gonna stay alive. Denies it.
Alright, I'm not really the biggest fan of denying the tier 3, but alright, let's see what happens now. They're chasing the Omni Knight. They could really use the skill. There's a Yules on Vina. There it is.
Well, goes up once, goes up twice, and...
Maybe third time?
No third time.
Unnecessary.
Well, Roche won't be up for another minute 30 for LOTV, so it looks like they're just going to have to give up their tier 3 and call it a day.
I mean, the best thing for LOTV from that last fight is that they had to spend no buybacks. They didn't spend any buybacks defending that, right? I think they didn't.
No, I'm fairly sure they didn't. I'm almost certain they didn't.
Yeah, PL died, but he didn't buyback. So, I mean, he didn't have the buyback either. But I feel like LOTV is just missing damage. Like, they do not have that enough damage to deal with this team, especially versus that Omni Knight. That's why I'm even saying, if they get the Omni Knight, maybe they can fight off afterwards. But if they do not kill that Omni Knight, there's absolutely nothing they can do. This position 4 Leshrac is nice, it's cute, but if you, I mean, if you have repel on your cores, like, the Leshrac is useless, it does absolutely nothing.
Yep.
And they smoked up, they're probably gonna board some deep places here around the pit.
He could Diabolic Edict, you know? It's, not very threatening, I mean, but he can do it.
Yeah, I don't think that's... Yeah.
Middle lane. They're just gonna take off Charlie. Yeah, no problems there.
They're pinging out Cube, but no. Rush about to spawn. They're gonna put the courier inside. Check it, and it's up.
There we go, straight away. The radiant courier actually goes down.
Sneaky Vagamama.
Oh, it's just the Wagger illusion, doing its job.
Yeah.
Well, here we go, LOTV going for the Roshan. Now, can this be contested? They're actually going to use the scan for it, and they will see.
They should contest it, definitely. I don't know why they are not doing it.
They need to go now, though. They need to go now. The Roshan, he's falling low. 3,000 HP, 2,000 HP. The illusions are doing it. They're not going to get there nearly in time, though. Spectre coming in. Can she take this? It's getting low. 100 HP. It goes down, but Stormstormer picks up the Aegis immediately. Who got the cheese? I'm not even sure. As in come, they all going down here. They use the BKB on Stormstormer, but he's taking so much damage, and he doesn't actually survive. GA comes out. Wagga going to eat up that cheese. Meanwhile, they're actually trying to turn it around in this fight, as Wagga seems to be dropping. He's dropping. They've got the silence, but in comes a Golem from Hoverty. Waggered though, he gets swept away by a Crypt Swarm. And well, Jimmy's just gonna find the kill onto the Warlock here. Nothing he can really do about that. Meanwhile, Nightstalker getting caught out as well. It does look to be another victorious team fight for LOT. For London Esports this time.
For LOTV,
definitely not for LOTV.
Definitely not for them. And this Dominate is just gonna charge straight down mid like a boss, because.
Yeah, let's go.
He hasn't really died in any of these teams. Oh, he died 6 times. Oh, I have him muted. Nice. Never mind. Like, I really feel like they have to kill this.
Stormstormer just going in onto the Omni Knight. What were you saying exactly?
He tried.
Yeah, didn't quite manage it.
He tried.
Bring out the LSA was a nice idea, but the Omni Knight does have a Crimson Guard, a pipe, more importantly, and those drums, which tanking up quite a lot, and the middle barracks go down. Hello, TV. They're letting this game go.
I have a feeling that Vaga's Phantom Lancer is not doing a whole lot this game. I don't know if it's the itemization. This Heart of Tarrasque might have been a...
Yeah, I really feel the heart is kind of the biggest problem here.
Yeah, like, I really do not like that item. When he was buying it, I kind of felt like it was alright. It was a safe item, and they had a lot of damage between Cube and Lina already. So he could go for it. But they got picked off so many times from the moment he bought that heart that they kind of fell off, and now that heart is just an unnecessary item that makes him tanky, but eventually he dies anyway because he deals no damage, so...
Well, I imagine he's going for the Silver Edge next to kind of disable some of those Spectre passives and really get into Zibby's face this game, but...
That definitely wouldn't be a bad idea, but still, have to deal with the Omni first.
That's true, that's true. This Omni Knight has been the pinnacle of the London Esports team so far. Really keeping them alive, especially with the Pipe of Insight and the Crimson Guard. Add that to a skill set, and anybody that's near him is going to be a tricky old pickoff indeed.
You know what happened last game? Seep guy on Luna started farming somewhere alone. He got picked off a few times and LOTV turned. And that's almost what happened. Cube!
Ooh, Cube's coming in! They're too scared though. They know that the Omni Knight is here, so it is actually a terrifying prospect to come and fight this. Wagamon's hanging around, he's got this Shadow Blade, now comes out of Invis, and Zhiv will start the attack as they silence up the Omni Knight. Looks like they're gonna try and go for this one. They gotta try and bring down the Spectre, but it's such a tough job. But do they have the damage? The GA is popped, and now the ultimate from the Spectre as well, just gonna fly around, trying to make this as confusing as possible. Meanwhile, it's actually Wagamama who falls down, and Zhiv actually ends up getting the last hit onto him. Now BKB Exorcism is out. The Warlock goes down. They get the grip off onto Eskil as well. They'll pop that BKB, but we'll look over to the Lina, who gets picked off once, and the Aegis coming back around number two. Shibby's hiding in the trees. Does not want to get Laguna Bladed to the face, and is just going to hide up and then jump back in, and they will find yet another pickoff. So four heroes dead. Eskil able
another
to escape on the backlands with his BKB, but yeah, absolutely. Fantastic.
Another good team fight for LOTV.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Well,
I mean, they kind of played on that, what I was talking about, right? They kind of went for that Spectre, thinking, all right, this guy, maybe he's alone again.
They're going here. Actually, repelling the bait to get him out of that silence. But here we go. Buyback first used from Lina. They also have it on Wagamama as well, but four heroes defending. They have no Golem. It's not a pretty sight. It's not a pretty sight, and I get the feeling they're going to lose a second lane of Rax here. Don't know why, just some weird feeling inside my stomach.
Way,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
You have like some talent, some hidden talent. You can see into the future. Like you should.
I don't know.
You're
maybe,
wasting
maybe
yourself here. Man.
Should be a TV clairvoyant.
Yeah.
Tell people about their dead parents. Anyway, BKB popped on Stormstormer, going hard onto the Bane here. And, well, Nightmare himself, but doesn't keep him alive for that long. They've taken the melee barracks, and that is all they want as they choo-choo out of this one. One behind the other, Cube coming forwards. I'm a Disco Pony, and I want to do some damage as he throws himself up into the air. Everybody's in the air. It's Cyclones all around, but now they find the stun out onto Mad King's here. Can they bring him off in time? No, they cannot find the stun, so he is going to get that repel off, but the right-click damage, it should be enough, surely. It should be enough. But they're chasing him down, they can't quite find him, and now the rappel runs out. Mad King's trying to take them on a joyride, but finally caught out in the open, coming back to the earth as that yours runs out, and they finish off the Omni Knight. But they have lost a barracks, and it is a very, very small silver lining to this dark grey cloud that has fallen over LOTV this game.
Playing without two sides versus Spectre, and that Prophet is not really where you want to be in this game, especially when you're
maybe getting more here, as they've actually managed to find the Death Prophet and then the Aeon Dispels, but in comes Jimmy. Let's go, he says. It was all a bait all along as Stormstormer's being chased down here. Don't forget, no buyback on this Lina. And now, well, they throw up to the air, but Stormstormer's already dead. Cube trying to jump in and do as much as he can. Eskil as well with the BKB also, but it doesn't take long for them to bring down Cube, and it just feels like Zhiv is completely out of control. He's got the Aegis, he's got the Butterfly, he's got the Manta, even picked up a Vanguard to go for that Abyssal eventually. There is very little which LOTV can do versus this Spectre and the people on his team.
Wagga pulls.
Wagga is going for the kill onto the Bane. Okay, we'll get it. Now, let's see if it pays off.
Definitely.
Yeah, I think it's worth. I think it's worth. He's got the buyback.
Yeah, that Bane bought his cloak, so you have to stop his item progression. You can't let him have that Glimmer
Cape.
Yeah,
if he gets Glimmer Cape, it's pretty much over. Just in case you're wondering, we are talking out our asses right now. It's Shiv comes down, just trying to find whoever he can. The Shadow Fiend incarnate of Golem running around punching things in the face, but it's Come With Me getting very low as Wagak actually coming in. Might be able to kick off the second support. He's making his way up the chain. He's killed the 5, he's killed the 4, but could he kill the 3? I think maybe not. As Eskil, they just seem to be punching into nothing right now. Mad King's so very tanky. They bring the Golem in as well. What can they do though? GA even popped in this one, so as if they were doing nothing in the first place, now they're doing very little indeed. And Jibby just turns around and kills a Thorn in the side, which was cute. Now BKB popped up from Eskil again. He's so low on health though, it's only going to take a few right clicks to bring him down, but they do need to be close enough for him to do that, and it isn't. Suddenly turning to daytime, and Eskil suddenly finds it very difficult to get away from Jibber and Mad Kings. They pick off another one. There's only one hero on the side of LOTV left alive. They do have the buyback on the Nightstalker, but something tells me might not be enough to hold on to this game.
I don't think... Do you think they're gonna actually push this? Lina is coming alive. They shouldn't. No, they're gonna go back. Maybe take this... Maybe go for the Shrine. Maybe go completely back. They're definitely not gonna go for high ground. However... That last teamfight, DL had to buy back, and yeah, his item progression is kind of ruined. He is going for that Silver Edge, which he's gonna have, but is it gonna be enough? That's the question.
I mean, you know, I've been playing a bit of Spectre recently. I do hate it when people build the Silver Edge against me, because... Uh-oh. Wagga, no! Wagga, no! Oh, no!
Yeah, you said you hate it when people buy Silver Edge against you.
Exactly, and they stopped him buying it, which is exactly the reason they're going to win this game.
This Bane did not let that happen.
Exactly. Lovely commitment there. Yeah, see, they're just guarding the secret shop now. They're just not letting the courier there either. Yeah, they know.
Just a casual double damage on Spectre as well. Getting some mana, has her ulti. I don't think you have to... you don't have to initiate with your ulti here. You can go in, maybe die, buy back, use your ulti if things go south.
That's true.
Just to be extra sure. But yeah, you can just start off with ulti as well. I think this game is in the bag for them. I don't see... this Lina is strong, but she's not the sniper from the last game. I don't see her stopping the...
Yeah, it's quite a big difference. And in they go. The ultimate is popped from Spectre as well. Golem in return, though. Gonna penetrate those BKBs, but in we go. DB's gonna go down. Stormstormer trying to do a bit of damage onto the Death Prophet, but where is the Spectre? She's just running through this fight, basically doing whatever she wants. Meanwhile, Cube getting brought down, though. Just can drop very quickly. The Mystic's Flare coming down now. There's a Nightstalker held still by that Aatos, and look at all of these ghosts tearing them apart. And GG is called. London Esports, they're gonna make it a 1-1. Despite what people thought, they prove them wrong.
Warlock vote back to write in GG well played.
Nice.
And that's it.
Just make sure he ends up with the worst net worth possible.
Living up to the position 5 dream, man.
Exactly. It's what everybody aims to be. You know, position 1s, they want to get as high net worth as possible. Position 5s, they want to get as low net worth as possible. But, you know, of course it's going to be Bane who wins that. He always does. 3k, definitely. 3k net worth. Better than last game, I think.
he did not finish his Glimmer Cape while Hovi did, so maybe that's...
Wagamama made sure of that one, that's for sure.
Yeah, maybe that's the thing. Don't buy the Glimmer Cape, Hovi, next game and you might win.
That's the advice from our analysis today, is it? One word of advice to LOTV is don't buy Glimmer Capes. And
Hovi, what are you thinking, man? Buy more sense.
And maybe get the Silver Edge before the Harder Tarrasque next time, I think, on Wagamama. Jibby turned out to be much bigger of a problem than perhaps LOTV really
I don't think it's only the itemization.
Oh, sure.
It's the way you envision the game going, that's why you itemize the way you itemize. However, it just didn't pan out that way. He had like 3k gold in stash, and they were winning these fights when he had the 3k gold. And so... buying a heart is like, all right, guys, I'm just going to be that dude that runs in, makes a lot of chaos while you clean up, because it seems that you guys have enough of ammunition in your arsenal to actually take them down. And that's what's in his head. However, it just didn't happen. They got caught time after time. And once that Spectre got Radiance, it just turned the fights completely around. It wasn't even just about her Radiance. It's about this combination with Mad King's Omni Knight. And if you remember when they tried to get her on tier 2 on top, that was the Luna from the last game.
A
Luna that has no save. That's how LOTV turned these games. They got a few pickoffs on him. However, this game,
It was the Omni Knight just stopped them being able to get those pickoffs, and I love to see teams when they realize what went wrong in their last game, they correct it in the next game, and then they pull off a win, and that's got to be very satisfying for
yeah, that
these
has
games.
To be the feeling is that feeling is the best, yeah, especially
very nice. Alright, you can also sorry, you can see in the graph as well the whoops moment from LOTV, that one team fight which went horribly wrong. I think it was in the middle lane, just giving Jibby a bunch of kills, and things just went horribly wrong after that. Another team fight, and then the Roshana as well, and then the barracks, and just so many things. And eventually, London Esports just kind of, yeah, they just swung it. They swung it hard.
I mean, they were in control for the most of the last game as well. Let's not forget that LOTV did not really put up their best performance that last game either. London Esports was in control the whole game up until that Aghanim's moment with Luna. So they kind of failed there. They tilted. Luna got picked off a few times. That's why they lost. While this game, no. They did not have the greatest laning stage, as we said, because of the draft. But with Omni Knight and with Spectre, they came back, and this looked fairly simple for them.
Yeah, it certainly did. Playing some textbook Dota 2, but fantastic to watch. Are you excited to see London Esports in action a little bit more?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
Right. Well, I think that's it from us today. And in terms of games coming up in the Join Dota League today, well, you got one more game coming up at 12:30. Sorry, 1:30. CST, that'll be Thundercats versus Wolf over in the NA division. And that'll be with Robin Roll, but from us, it's goodbye. You're going to be playing in the TI qualifiers tomorrow?
I might have some fun stack in stash for myself. I do not have a real stack right now. I'm playing with some stacks, but nothing really super serious. So I might just get a few guys to have fun, and that's it.
Cool. Sounds good. Playing Dota for fun. There's a novel idea which other people should perhaps take on board. I'm going to be following the games over on my channel if anybody wants to come and watch those, but for us, it's going to be goodbye, and we'll catch you maybe next week for some more JDL action. See you then.
Cheers.